Did you ever have a time where you realized a good friend wasn't actually your friend?
So I was going out with my friend for his birthday, and before I got over there, his first words to me was, "Why do you look better than me on my birthday?" Then while I was belligerently drunk, he was taking my phone without my knowledge, said that his phone was dead, and was using my card for everything. Meaning I paid for all the drinks, all the Ubers, and I didn't even know it because I was belligerently drunk. A week later, he was trying to get half of my videos taken down and tried to get my account taken down and then blocked me. And we were supposed to be friends for 5 years. I wish him well, though.
Did you ever have a time where you realized a good friend wasn't actually your friend?
All right, so I can't resist when it comes to coming across videos like this. So I've always kept my circle really small, and I had one best friend, and she was my best friend for 15 years. I liked her so much, I hooked her up with my brother, but then she dated my other brother. Now, I let that go, and then my abusive ex-boyfriend cheated on me with her. I'm like, I'm not really happy about that. And then she started dating my dad. And I was definitely not happy about that, and I moved away and tried to stay as far away from them as possible. They would put on a good face for me, but I wasn't falling for it. But the kicker was when I had my stroke. I was literally on my deathbed with a 1% chance of survival. That's when she tried to take my children. Her and my dad locked my oldest in a room and interrogated her for hours. They told my kids I died. Their harassment got so bad when I was in a coma that a safe house had to be set up for my family. And then the audacity when it turned out I was going to survive. I stood up and cut my dad out of my life and my children's life. And she had the nerve to say I was unreasonable. How dare I get mad at my father? How dare I get mad at her? How dare I get mad at them for them trying to take everything from me? And how dare I refuse to find forgiveness in my heart? The relief I have for cutting them out of my life is awesome, and I am much happier now.
Did you ever have a time where you realized a good friend wasn't actually your friend?
I told my best friend at the time that I was considering getting weight loss surgery, and she said, "Oh my God, that's great. Could you do it before my wedding?"
Did you ever have a time where you realized a good friend wasn't actually your friend?
Yes. Left club with my homegirl. We're following three guys. She has one of her numbers from inside the club. I'm thinking we're going to another bar. They pull up to a condo. I'm like, "What's going on?" She's like, "They're about to pay us $2,000 each so that they can have sex with us." I said, "No." She said, "We need this money." I said, "I don't need this money. You might need this money. You can go ahead and go. I'm not going with them." And they wouldn't take her without me. So then after they called us a bucket up, then we got back in the car. She proceeded to call me names and told me to drive over to this restaurant that's open late across the street. So I drove over there. I passed out drunk in the driver's seat, and she called somebody, had them come pick her up, and she left me with my car running, passed out in the driver's seat with my purse out and all the doors unlocked. And I knew then that she was not my friend.
Did you ever have a time where you realized a good friend wasn't actually your friend?
So I moved to LA about 4 years ago with a roommate that I called a friend for about 15 years before that. We agreed to split the rent 50-50. The first month we got there, the job wasn't coming through. Of course, I had his back. I paid the rent. It's fine. It's not a big deal. 1 month turned into 2 months, turned into 3 months. He still hadn't heard back from the job, and I was still paying the rent. But what happened was he got lazy and started to sleep in all day and smoke weed all day. And 3 months turned into 6 months and still no job, not being proactive about finding a job. And he decided to take a trip back home and never came back, left me with all of his furniture, all of his stuff. And on top of that, told everyone back home that he was paying my rent and I was smoking weed all day and being lazy all day, which was a complete lie.
Did you ever have a time where you realized a good friend wasn't actually your friend?
My best friend of 10 years from high school stole my identity, and then he claimed me on his taxes. I was kind of having a rough time. I was staying with my parents and I couldn't take it anymore. And so I moved out and I moved in with him. I moved in with him to help them out with bills and to help me out, get out of this situation that I was in. He was struggling really hard with bills, and I ended up selling my motorcycle to help him get caught up on bills because he asked me to sell it to help pay the bill. And he promised, he was like, hey, you know, I'll give you my car. You can use my car to go get work. That never happened. I ended up having to walk 4 miles and catch several buses in order to just make it to work on time every day. I was leaving at like 4 a.m. and getting home roughly about 8 or 9 o'clock at night. Now, mind you, there are three people there, plus a child. I was paying half of the bills, was told I couldn't have a key, was left waiting outside in the rain, the cold, for several hours at a time. When I asked for a key, I was told that it was going to be a problem. After about 3 months, I'd had enough. I was like, no, screw this. I'm not going to be sitting outside waiting after I just get off of work. Most nights, I wouldn't get enough sleep. And it was taking a toll on my mental health. From there, it just got worse. Every single night, they were having people over till midnight, 1 o'clock in the morning. Mind you, I get up at 4 a.m. I'm sleeping in the living room. After a few months, I had saved up enough to get myself a car. And the night that I got my car, I packed up all of my shit and I left. Because I would have rather slept in my car than to be put through that. About a month later, I go to do my taxes. I'm told, no, you've already done your taxes. I was like, no, no, I haven't. To which I then found out that somebody had claimed me on their taxes. After doing a little bit of digging around, I found that my best friend had used my social security information to claim me as a dependent on his taxes. So I did what any logical, sane person would do. I went and reported him to the IRS. Now, correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure stealing from the IRS is considered a federal crime, which if he was convicted would be considered a felony. And I do happen to know that he is on TikTok. So what do you say, guys? You want to get this on as FYP?
Did you ever have a time where you realized a good friend wasn't actually your friend?
I didn't think I'd actually get to talk about this one. My senior year of high school, I was still friends with the same six people I had known since middle school. So at this point, roughly all of us had been friends for like 6 years. I'll admit that, you know, in a group that large, some people hang out more with others, and I didn't really get to leave my house that much for a very complicated set of reasons. But I still considered every single one of them my friend, and I hung out with them in school every opportunity that I got. If we shared classes, if we shared lunch, you know, socializing as much as I could. Also, I'm pretty sure that some of them now see my content and follow me and watch me. I'm pretty confident, so if you're one of those people, you know who you are, and this is for you, and this is how you hurt me. Senior year, one of my friends out of that group was hosting an after party from prom and also a sleepover, so everyone was going over to her house and staying the night after prom. I found out about this secondhand from one of my other friends in that group that was going and was invited, and so I went and I talked to the girl who was hosting and I said, hey, I didn't get an invite yet, like, is this still a thing that's going on? Can I go? Like, I'm not just going to insert myself into the situation, I'm going to ask permission first. And she looks me dead in the eyes, and she says, no, you're not invited. I was stunned. I didn't know what I had done that was wrong. I didn't know who I had pissed off. I didn't know what I had said. I didn't know what I had, like, why wasn't I invited? Why did I felt intense rejection? In my shock, the only thing I could say to her was, okay, and then I walked away from that conversation. That conversation was kind of a wake-up call that made me think about my relationships with the people in that group, and I realized that at most I was just an acquaintance to them. I had voiced my opinion to other people in the group, and I said, hey, I was really upset that I didn't get an invite, and nobody really said anything along the lines of, yeah, you should have been invited. So that was kind of a key moment for me. So, yeah, I mean, I wish I had just known earlier instead of spending, like, some 4 or 6 odd years thinking that an entire group of people were actually friends with me and not just tolerating my existence.
She's a wacky, crazy lady. He's a rich, rich man. She moved to the state of California.